Hello everyone, Melcadrien here, and welcome back to more Monolith. Let's get our daily wisdom from clients here. Found anything interesting down there? I never get further than a floor in, most of the time. Maybe it's all for the better. Don't want to get my fur wet anyway. Decisions are the lifeblood down there. Down here. Most things get lost quickly, so it matters what you pick and when. This is why it's so great to be me. I've made only great decisions in my life. I wonder what drove you here. Curiosity? Scarcity? Desperation? Ambition? Why am I here? Well, it's complicated. You said that in the previous episode. Anyways, let's enter the monolith, see what we can find, and see if we can actually beat the three levels. It's funny, even I'm still dying on the first three levels. It just shows how hard and unrelenting this game is, even for demo. Alright, let's upgrade, see what we have. Plating, discount, and fortune. Oh, all good options. I am gonna have to go with fortune on this one. Because I prefer, well, more item drops. In a way. Here's hoping it doesn't bite me in the butt, though. Nope. You don't kill me. You don't get to kill me. There we go. You know, I wonder what the top score could be for a game like this. I mean, there has to be a height and upper threshold. Because each enemy could drop... Each enemy could only drop so much, and with a multiplier, they drop a little more than that. So when you max it out, I gotta wonder, how much can you actually get from an enemy? And if you have it at the max, low-grade enemies, and then fighting the high-grade enemies, I wonder how much money you could actually scare up through that. Interesting thought, to say the least. Of course, killing these won't give you any scrap, which makes sense, otherwise you could basically farm the score. And let's be honest, I don't want anyone to farm the score. That ruins part of the appeal for some of the gamers. For some of the people who want to play this game. You don't want anyone to ruin the high score by just farming those. It just ruins it. You want to make it competitive. Short bursts, facade in front of you. Reflective. Slows enemies. Choices. Let's go with sword. Reflecting bullets might be useful. Might be useful. Well, I think it worked. Well, maybe. Of course it won't work on that. Because, of course, it's not a projectile. It's an electrical beam. A beam of death. a death beam. So, we have money. That's got a 10% damage increase. Bingo! First try. And we found the vault key. So, this is the part where I'm going to talk about other stuff. So, this is actually on the same day where I've actually recorded the previous episode. So this is pretty much the same day that Persona 5 was released, I believe. And, well, let's just say Atlas may have goofed up. Bad. Big time. Because, let's be honest, restricting pretty much everything in a game for people to show off, it just gives a bad impression of it. That's just my opinion of it, though. Other people may agree that, yes, it's spoilers, but to others it's like, really? From what I've heard, a lot of people are returning, refunding, boycotting the company. Me? Well, I kind of just want to see how this will turn out for now. Because I don't want to endorse people returning, refunding their games. But people will do it regardless. Anyways, what we have for upgrades. Blink, extra power, recovers all health and ammo. Well, I've tried blink before, but I prefer more speed when I blink. Of course, it wouldn't hurt to blink past some bullets, unless it's a huge hail of bullets. Let's try extra power. Okay, it gives me a maximum extra bomb. Good to know. Yeah, I do not know what Atlas is gonna do, if they're actually going to rescind this ban, as I'm naming it, because let's be honest, it pretty much sounds like a ban, but it's not a overt ban. But then again, from what I have learned, this has been going on since the JP release. So, them changing this, it's probably going to be difficult considering this is basically starting from Japan itself. So we're just going to have to, I think it's just best to just sit and wait on it. I guess those who have physical copies can basically sit on their copies. Or if they really want to make a point, they'll probably end up returning it for a refund. Because what's the best way to... You know what? Let me open this up to discussion. What do you guys think would be a good way to... Would be a good way to get people to... Think. Business-wise. Make them think that what they've done is wrong and needs to be fixed. Let me just open that up. Because, let's be honest, it's an interesting discussion. Just remember, keep it family. You know, I keep it teen rated. At least teen rated. In the comments below. Anyways, let's see. Homes into enemies and splits. I wonder what that does. Anyways, that's my thought on the whole ban on the whole Atlas Persona thing going on. But yeah, I'm gonna leave that up to this, up to open for discussion. If you think it, if you think they're in their right, and they are right about it, comment about it. If you think they're wrong, and they need to change it, same thing. I am going to this discussion is open. Just make sure that you keep it teen and a teen level, because I know there are people who are sensitive to certain things. Anyways, enough of all that. Let's just get back to the game. Well, I'm certainly doing well. And we found the shop. We also found a shrine. Let's see, Vulcan goes to the first enemy. Homes onto enemies, arcs between enemies, fires in short bursts. That's an interesting combination there. I'm gonna hold off on buying anything right now. It's a good thing I remembered how to use the bomb this time round, because I knew I was pinned. I knew I was pinned right there. So that pretty much worked out for me. There we go, increases max ammo slightly. Okay. Let's see. Oh my. I don't have the money for it. I'm gonna have to see if I can fight the boss for it. That's probably gonna be difficult considering it's the daemon. And I have the fireball. Well, it was certainly a good attempt, but it seems to have not worked out well. So, mark it off for boss busting. Well, at least I have the money. Just mark it off for boss busting, and it will be a useful weapon. On. There we go. I want to check something. Go into my options, controls. So, when you pick up a weapon, you can't get rid of it. That's good to know. Part of the decisions is the lifeblood in this place. Well, I got a new weapon and I've got a lot of ammo for it. Not bad. Short bursts. It's kind of like a, well, it's like a burst machine gun. A real fast burst machine gun at that. Very nice. That's scary. I'm sorry, that was very scary when it did that. on, die. Sheesh. That enemy had a lot of health. Whew. That was close. Ooh, that was even closer. And the upgrade machine, what do we have? Autobomb, discount, or salvage? Well, I don't think I'm going to be salvaging anything. So let's get the discount. I saw you there. It's nice that the water is actually slowing the bullets down. That's a really nice effect there. The bullet's just slowing down while it's in water. Whew. Alright, next Nimbus. Nope. Got him. Okay. So far, so good. We're doing good here. Oh geez, they jumped! They were fast jumpers at that. Oh my goodness. Did you see how fast they jumped, even when I dashed? Those have incredible reaction time. Damage increase. I am just incredibly surprised that they did that. Woof. You do not want that jumping up into your face. It will be like, surprise, and then it bites your face off. Every effect damage over time. Shoots and bursts of pellets. Oh jeez, that's the shotgun iceballs. Yes, shotgun iceballs. Yes, I know I have less than max ammo, but shotgun ice balls. You know, I'm gonna save this for the boss. It's the Devourer. I still have enough ammo when I actually fight the boss proper. I did just burn out all my bombs. Well, my multiplier is dead. At least that gives me extra health. Let's try for... Well, seeing as I already beat the game, I might as well see if I can get a higher score. Ah, adds two bombs. Okay, very nice. I could use that as panic. Okay, now that we have two extra bombs, might as well see if I can find the secret room. Wherever that is. Bingo. Okay, max ammo increase. Well, another run complete. So our victory total is 2 out of 2. So what's our score, I hope you guys are enjoying this game as much as I am, which is a whole lot. Dang! That isn't exactly a high score. I guess I took too many hits in some of the fights. Oh well, I guess that's gonna be our score for today. Not great, but certainly can be better. I just need to learn not to get hit. So until next time, this is Melcadrien, and this is the playthrough of Monolith. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment down below, follow me on Twitter and or Tumblr if you want to. I do, however, appreciate it a whole lot. Thank you. You all have a wonderful day, and happy gaming. Okay, then.